I wanted to tell you a story that will teach us a little bit about life. Sometimes we do things that later on we realize how horrible what we just did, and now it's time to pay the price. One old man is going to daven mincha in the evening in Bnei Brak. There's a big shul, it's called Itzkovich. Hundreds of people gather every evening to pray one minyan after the other. And the old man is looking for a ride to Jerusalem. He has to go to an engagement and the engagement party, and he's looking for somebody to give him a ride. Finally he found a person that is going to Jerusalem. And then on the way, you know, once they enter Jerusalem, the old man asked the driver if he can do him a favor and make a right and take him about 2 or 3 minutes up the hill. The driver said that he's very sorry, he can't, he just can't because he's in a rush. He has somewhere to go tonight, and if he doesn't mind just to get off here and, you know, maybe to manage on his own. But the old man says, what do you care? It's going to take 3-4 minutes for you. For me, it's going to be half an hour walking all the way up the hill. I'm old. Come on, do it. You did a mitzvah. Do it perfectly. The driver says, I'm very sorry. I would do it in another day, but today I'm very busy. I'm in a rush. I don't have even this 10 minutes to waste back and forth to come here. Please get off. But the old man is not giving up. The old man says to him, we know, you know, according to the Torah, when you start a mitzvah, you have to finish it. You have to do it perfectly, not on and off. You got to do it in the right way. You did 98% of the mitzvah. Don't you want to do a little bit more and make it perfect? So the driver said, why don't you understand? I just told you that I want to do it, but I can't. I just can't. Just please get off. You're keeping me here waiting. I have to run. But the old man is not giving up. The old man says, I'm very sorry. You know, you should know next time if you're thinking not to do 100% of the mitzvah, don't start. It's better not to start than to do almost perfect. So the driver says, I don't understand. Where do you get this chutzpah from? Please just get off my car. Get off. He begins to scream. So the old man says, I'm telling you, you have to do the mitzvah in the right way. So the driver says, you know what? I'll teach you how to do a mitzvah in the right way. He takes the car, he makes a U-turn, and begins to drive. The old man is saying, what are you doing? So I'm taking you back all the way to Bnei Brak. It's almost an hour ride. The old man says, no, stop, I'm in a rush. I have to go. He says, I'm very sorry. You say that if I cannot do the mitzvah perfectly, it's better not to start. I'm fixing what I did. I'm taking you to the beginning point. You start from there. And they're arguing the entire way, and he calls him names, and you can imagine what went there in a car. And he gets phone calls, the drivers, and he tells everyone, what the old man with such nerve, how can it be? Once they got to Bnei Brak, get off the car, he screams. The old man got off the car, and he went back to Jerusalem, the driver. Now the old man, he must get to Jerusalem. Looking around, he found another ride. He's getting to Jerusalem. In the meantime, the driver ran home, he changed his clothes. What happened? His daughter is getting engaged tonight. So he himself is more than an hour late to his daughter's engagement party. He gets phone calls, yes, I'm running late, I'm sorry, he's fuming. He gets to the catering hall. Where have you been? It's already 9 o'clock. You're supposed to be at 7:30. Yeah, don't ask what happened. No. He comes in, and he said, let's start, it's very late. All of a sudden, the father of the groom, he said, I'm very sorry, we're very nervous now. So what happened? He said, my father was supposed to be here an hour ago. We told him before 8. My father is very, very precise. He never been late ever. I don't remember ever that he was ever late for any meeting or anything. We're very worried that something maybe happened to him. So the father of the bride, he said, well, what can we do? We cannot sit and wait for your father. I'm very sorry. He said, listen, I don't have a clean head now to celebrate. Maybe something happened to my father. He's an old man. As they arguing if to start or not, The old man walked in the door with his cane. Who is the old man? The passenger that he took. The old man that he brought from Bnei Brak to Jerusalem. The old man sees that in the important table of all the family members, who is sitting? The driver that just brought him here before and took him back. The driver couldn't believe, this is your father? This is the grandfather of the groom? Oy vey, big problems. Right away, he calls his son. Why you marry your son to a family that you never checked? This guy has the nerve, he has such attitude. This is what he did to me. Look at me, only I got here at 9:30 instead of 7:30 because of him. As they all talking about what happened, the old man say, I'm very sorry. My grandson cannot marry this girl. I'm very sorry, with all the respect to the girl. With this kind of family, we don't want any business. The girl is crying, the guy is crying, the guests are in shock. And the wedding was called off, finished. This story was told by one of the greatest speakers that we had in the previous generation, Rav Shalom Shvadron, was giving his lectures was like electric. And by the end of the story, he said that he went to the chief rabbi of Israel at that time, in the whole world, the Chazon Ish in Bnei Brak, and asked him, Rabbi, someone who speaks to the crowd and wants to get them closer to God, is he allowed to make fiction stories, to make up stories, or to tell stories that never really happen in reality, to get them inspired? And the rabbi said, of course, it's a very big thing to get Jews closer to their father in heaven. If that's the way to do it, fine. Because every story teaches a lot about life. So the rabbi says to his crowd, and that's the story I just invented for the first time in my life, which means it never took place. That's the story. The story never happened in reality, but we all know that stories like this happen every day all over the world. People with the ego and anger, and this kind of people never ever realize that the little things that you do today will cost you later. The wedding could be canceled, and the children and grandchildren that's supposed to be born, everything is going to be canceled. And I will tell you a story that did happen. In reality, one truck driver is driving a truck with cement, you know, construction. He's in construction. One day he comes home, there's a sign by the driveway of his house, please do not block driveway. And he's very, very angry if somebody blocks his driveway. And one day he gets to the house, not only somebody blocked his driveway, someone is parking inside his driveway. A brand new car? No, hard to believe. He's honking and honking, nobody comes out. He say, you know what? I'm gonna teach this guy a lesson. He pull, reverse his truck, he pour all the cements that he has. Everything was poured on top of that car, brand new car. He takes a shovel, he attach all the cements around the entire car that nobody will be able to open the doors, nothing. Destroyed the car. As his anger relaxed a little bit because, you know, of all the revenge that he just had, he comes inside the house, 100 guests in the house, they all scream, Mazel Tov, surprise! He looks at them, Mazel Tov for what? What happened today? He says, it's your anniversary date with mommy, 30 years you are married, we decided to buy you a brand new car, here is the key. Here is the key. He said, brand new car? Where is the car? He said, what, you didn't see the car in the driveway? Brand new, blue, navy, beautiful, shiny car. He said, this is my car? Oy vey. I just destroyed it. Begins to cry, runs around like crazy. What do you mean? I thought that somebody parked in my car. I destroyed the car and there's no insurance. Only tomorrow, yeah, he had to go and make a plate and get insurance. The money is gone. Everything you do today, one day will pay the price. There's no way to run away. It's just that we are not aware of what we do today, and when the time comes to pay for it, we'll be very surprised and very disappointed. I hope that we will be wise enough to change our evil way and get to the right direction, as Hashem told us in our Torah. Thank you for listening.